Most of our projects take about a day. This one will take probably a little over a month to totally finish it. So you can just imagine how incredible it's gonna be. You give us a month to do something, we can do some pretty incredible stuff.
They're more excited about the pond than their house. They've designed the entire house around the viewing angles of the pond.
We're gonna do a big brick wall along here, and then that deck should hang out over this so it actually has the appearance that the water comes way back past it. 10 small semi-loads of dirt that have been hauled out of here, and I've only done about half the excavation. Hey everybody, it's Brian with Team Aquascape, and I just pulled up to a project that's been in the making for almost 3 years. I think it's actually been 3 years. We've been holding their fish for about 3 years, and we've been holding them because 3 years ago I met with them to go over their dream pond in their backyard, and they are definitely in the middle of construction. It is an epic pond. They have all kinds of bells and whistles, and so we're gonna try to figure out how to get through this gate over here. Might be the first time we actually break into a yard to build somebody a pond. Most of our projects take about a day, right? We do a lot of one day, 2 day type projects. This one will take probably a little over a month to totally finish it. So you can just imagine how incredible it's gonna be. You give us a month to do something, we can do some pretty incredible stuff. So let me see Chris over there lacing up the boots, getting all ready. I'm gonna take you guys in the backyard. We're gonna show you the design, and then we are gonna get at it. The two of us are just gonna kind of do a cleanup day today and get things prepped and ready for the rest of the crew throughout the total project. Give it a second.
Yeah,
talk about an open palette, huh? You can tell that this house has been under construction for 3 years. I mean, they've done nothing. Well, it was cool. They had, like, this is all a big add-on. They used to have a big patio right here. You can see the old pizza oven still sitting here, which we're gonna reuse and put into the new design. They used to actually have a pretty nice pond over here. It just wasn't taken to its fullest potential at all. A lot of small little cobbles, especially for such a big area. So we get this space to work with. They've designed the pond. I mean, they're more excited about the pond than their house. They've designed the entire house around the viewing angles of the pond.
Wow.
So they're outdoor people. You can see they've got these big, I call them cabo doors. You know, the doors that go, you know, and open up. So all of this can open up to be inside outside type viewing. Big giant sliding doors by their kitchen window. There's gonna be a hot tub over there. That's their bedroom. The master bedroom's on the first floor over there. There's gonna be a walkout that comes to a hot tub that's high into the pond. It's gonna be really cool. Chris and I are gonna get in here and just start kind of prepping this area. We've got a lot of bulldozing and stuff that just to clear all this out so we get really an open canvas to work with.
Second scoop of dirt on the project as far as excavation goes. You can see it's a blank canvas now. We've got all of disgusting, weedy soil that Brian scraped all of this in through here, getting it down to our clean slate. They're in a pile. We are going to get rid of all of this over the next couple days. So we've got a trucking company coming in. They're gonna bring their own equipment and they're gonna go ahead and load it up and get rid of it for us. Right now what Brian's doing is he's gonna go ahead and start digging this part of the pond where the wall is going to sit, and this is where the big long steps going down into the pond are going to be, creating that very formal edge. Where I'm standing is going to be the upper portion of the deck that comes right out of the threshold of this main living area and through here. He's got some digging to do with that little guy. He's going to continue to pile it there, and then we're going to build our berm all back in through there. If anybody can do it, it's that man right there. Mm-hmm.
Well, you can see this is kind of we're over digging for the deck. We got this here, started digging all of this out. Hot tub will sit like kind of right in that space. And there, it's gonna be a really cool planter, kind of soften up the transition from our stone steps, this deck and the hot tub. Then we have got our water walls coming down that way. Berm is starting to get in over there. All that soil over there is like an epic amount. It's just the top layer from this yard, getting all those weeds out of here. You can really appreciate how much work goes in just for the prep of this thing. But we're just two of us out here. I think we did a pretty good job. Things are looking good. You can see how formal that edge is gonna be. We don't do a whole lot of right angled ponds, but right up next to the house, this is gonna look awesome. Believe it or not, that's only at 3 feet deep. It looks much deeper as you get in here, but I still got another foot to go. We gotta get the laser transit out here and shoot some more stuff. I'll probably come back tomorrow, maybe just by myself, and dig a little bit more, but I'm super happy on the progress for today. I love my job. All right, guys, I got a little motivated, stayed a little longer, and got a little more of this hole dug. I'm gonna walk down here. This is the end of day one, and kind of give you a walkthrough. I think I'll do it from the depths of the deepest part of the pond. Let's see if I can get down here for you. So this is pretty cool. So I'm sitting the bottom of my pond. Right here is where that deck kind of cantilevers out over the water to about here. So the idea is we're gonna do a big brick wall along here, and then that deck should hang out over this so it actually has the appearance that the water comes way back past it. Doing a nice solid wall here will give us just a clean look, hide and protect that liner, and then obviously give us a foundation for that cantilever deck that's hanging out over it. Where the machine is sitting, a little bit of shadow, is probably pretty close to, like, I'm just guessing right now, 6 to 8 inches underneath water level, and then the waterfalls will come in from above that. So I'll probably end up shaving this down and get this down into like the 2 foot range. I hit an enormous amount of gravel right in here, and I can only guess it's maybe where the old septic tank was, and they use that to fill that all in. I'm just not quite sure. So I'm gonna wait and see if I can't find out from the homeowner before I start digging into that too much. Over here on this wall, again, we're gonna do our stack slate walls all the way up, and then the hot tub sits right about here. And we'll have those stack slate walls continue up to hide the face of the hot tub and then spill over. Right in here, there's kind of a little planter to help soften the transition from where this wall and the hot tub wall all meet together. So a big boxed planter, and I haven't quite figured out what we're gonna do that out of, wood or our walls or stucco to kind of match the house, maybe even that stone. That's what we should do, but we'll see. Over in this area, as I continue to go back, will be a bog beach area, water, like it goes way back there. That corner there is like the peninsula of our waterfall, so big falls coming this way. And then if I come up over in here, this is gonna be a continued deck. So this is kind of where that jog in the drawing was. Continued deck that overhangs. Remember, this side too also gets a giant stair the entire length of this off of the deck coming down into the water. Right over in there would be the swim up part of the pond. If you wanted to call it a swim up bar, you could, but it'll be more of a seat wall on the other side for the sunken fire pit. And you can see how much dirt I've generated. So I can't go too much further. I would love to dig all of this stuff out and just continue to dig, but I'm really running out of real estate. So tomorrow, hopefully the dirt gets removed and they've figured out all the trucking to get that stuff out of here. And then I can keep going on this. Not bad for a day. I think I got sunburned. Hey, I don't know what day it is. I think it's day three-ish maybe for me out here. I am in Downers Grove working on what's one of my favorite projects of the year. Can you see me? There we go. Just stopped out here to see how things were going. I'm out all by myself again, but the reason I wanted to come out here is because they were moving all that dirt for me back here. Right now they're on their 8th 6-wheeler. So 8 6-wheelers so far have come out. I think we have 2 more to go out. So that's 10 small semi-loads of dirt that have been hauled out of here, and I've only done about half the excavation. So I'm guessing we're gonna get another, at least another 10 out of here. We'll save some for the berm up and over here, but pretty awesome. Things got a little messed up due to some rain over the weekend, but it's coming together nicely, especially for the lack of people that are out here. The rest of the crew is still out to build into some different water features throughout the Chicagoland area here. But I love the progress. Things are coming along nicely. Remember, again, right in here is gonna be a kind of a big waterfall. So dirt's gotta get built up here, but I've got so much more to dig out in here just for depth. Hot tubs over there. So the next thing I'm gonna do is kind of come in here, mark this out, and give me a line on where to dig this garbage out. I still have no idea what that gravel is. Nobody knows. Hopefully it doesn't cause too big of a problem. One of the tough things about working in small backyards is obviously the access. And so you've got this stuff in the way over here. You have a really tight area to come by the side of the house. Watch this guy just kind of squeeze through here. I hear him coming. He's got plenty of room to turn around over here, but this is where it's challenging. Just cutting through here, and all of that stuff's got to get loaded out through the front yard. This is also going to be the same pathway all of our boulders have to come in. So over 200 tons of rock have to come down through there and then back into here. So the logistics of this project is really the most challenging. The design and the installation will be the fun part.